Hello, welcome to your June boot camp. So excited that you guys are here with me today. I'm doing a little makeup inside today. So we are gonna need heavy weights. I have 15 pounds. And then if you have a long band like this, you can use one of those. If you don't have a long band, it's not a problem. You can use your dumbbells and you can also use mini bands. So I have a heavy and a light mini band. So make sure you have those available as well. Again, we can modify all kinds of things, so if you don't have those, it's not a problem at all. So let's go ahead and warm up, right? We're just gonna take our legs wide and just get our knees moving side to side here. Open up the inner thighs. Perfect. And from here, we're just gonna add a little bit of a twist through the shoulders and torso. And one more time on each side. And then we're gonna hold it all the way over to one side and reach. And switch. So try to look up at your hand as you reach. Butt is back nice and low. And one more on each side. Good. Last one here. Come right down the middle. Hips are high. And then toe heel your feet in just a touch. And squat down low. And then reach up high. Let's do it again. Squat down low. Elbows to knees. And reach. Good, as you're squatting, make sure that you're not tipping forward. And you've got two more. All right, adding on, bootstrappers are next. So stay in the squat position, take your hands to your knees or your calves, and straighten the legs, and bend. Perfect, from that side view, looks like this, butt low, butt high, warming the quads, stretching the hamstrings. Also a little stretch for the ankles as well. And one more time, and hold. Roll yourself all the way up. Put yourself into a lunge position with your back heel down to begin with. So a calf stretch right here off the bat. And then we're gonna tuck our knee under our hip, back heel pops off the ground. And we're gonna lift up as we reach our arms, and then push back as our arms go back. I'm sorry, as we come up to the top of the lunge. So reach and push. Good. Try and keep that front knee lined up over the midfoot. And one more time. And hold back. Now drop the heel again right here. Hold. Clasp your hands together. And then bring your fingers behind your ears and lift your heel up off the ground. Waking up through the calf and the bottom of the foot. Elbows wide. And one more time. And switch to the other foot. Remember, we start with our heel down and back. Just hang out there for a moment. And then we tuck our knee, back heel pops off the ground. We reach our arms up and then push back. So balance action as well. Always working on that, right? Good, you've got two more. So you're really pushing those arms back behind, creating lots of range of motion in the shoulders. Hold and drop the heel. Bring the hands together for a moment. Lean forward. And then put your fingers behind your ears. Lift up onto the toes, drop the heel. And you've got two more right there. And done. All right, little hip opener here. Sorry, I'm gonna retie my shoe. All right, so standing on one leg, circle your knee around. You might feel some popping and grinding. Opening up that hip. Go in the opposite direction. Good, finding balance, use the wall if you need to. We've got kind of a fun theme day today, so hope you're gonna like it. About 5 minute intervals, we're going back to those 5x1s. Okay, so knee taps over and back. Good, one more in each direction and switch. So all you have to do is just follow along. You don't have to think, don't have to worry about it, just work hard. It's gonna be so much fun. And you've got two more. And then switch in the opposite direction. Nice big circles. These circles can be low on the ground, more like this. All right, tap it over and back. Over and back, just like you're dancing. Good, almost there. One more in each direction. And done. All right, rotation side to side. Reach all the way through for me. Waking up through the middle of the body. Nice stretch through the back of the shoulders as well. Make sure you're pivoting. If you can see my feet, we got pivoting action here. This is gonna be important for later. We're gonna throw some punches in our kickboxing set. So You want to make sure that you have that internal rotation in the hip. Good. Now reach up a little bit higher, still rotating, still pivoting. And one more, and hold. All right, so we're gonna stay in this little squat position here, and we're gonna pivot in, and then squat down. Pivot in, and squat. So if you can feel what's happening here, okay? This leg comes in, working through the hip. Your stabilizing leg mostly stays where it's at. It might have a little bit of a rotation, but we're pivoting in, and there's power coming right through this movement. So I want you to just practice, because later on I'm gonna ask you to do it. And switch to the other side. Pivot in, like you're trying to burn a hole in the carpet. And sometimes it's hard to pivot on carpet, but do your best. And one more time here, and done. All right, we are loose and ready to rock. So, starting with our band, the theme for this round is single, single, double, hold. So if you don't have a long band, you're just gonna use dumbbells. All right, we're gonna run through all the exercises real quick, and then we're gonna put them together in a 5 minute set. So here's what the first one looks like. Okay, we've got push press. Now, if you have band, the best way to make it gentler or easier is only one foot. If you wanna make it harder, you're gonna put both feet on the band. So just keep in mind, this is just the practice round, right? So push press is really like a mini squat and then a press up, okay? Mini squat, press up. So just do a couple of those. If this feels a little intense, you also can do single arms if you would like to. And it doesn't matter which foot is on the band, you're not gonna work that leg harder, just probably more for comfort, okay? Whichever one feels best. Or you can do both legs on the band. Okay, next exercise after that, bicep curl, same idea. One leg easier, two legs harder. I like to cross the band here, and bicep curls. So standing tall, knees are soft, bicep curls. Again, this can be done with dumbbells, if that's what you have. All right, one more time, and rest. All right, next up, lunges. No band on this one. We will use weight. We already warmed up lunges, but we'll do a couple here on each side. All right, perfect. Switch to the other side. Now, when we get into this next set, okay, I'm gonna ask you to do something like a single leg, and then a double leg. How do you do double lunge? That's really hard, right? So here's what it looks like. Practice, single, single, double is a squat, and then we're gonna hold it down in a squat. So let's practice that one more time. So single, single, double leg is a squat, go back down and hold. All right, so you'll have many more opportunities to practice that. Tricep overhead. All right, so with both handles, this is where it gets a little tricky, okay? So tricep presses. Now, if this is a little much, okay, because sometimes the band can be a little tight, right? You can use dumbbells, overhead tricep extensions. You're gonna do a single, a double, and then you're gonna hold it back. Okay, lots of tension going on there with that band. If you're using dumbbells, same idea, right? Single, single, double, and then hold, just like so. All right, next up, rows. With our band, or again, weights, just fine. Put the feet on the band, cross the band, hinge up the hips slightly, row, just like this, okay? Your single, single, double will look like this, single, single, double, then you go up for a hold with the shoulder blades pinched together. All right, we're ready to put this into action. It is 1 minute long, okay, for each set. All right, I have to get my timer set in front of me. Sorry about that. Okay, so we are ready to rock here. Feet under on the band. This is your squat press to begin with. Okay, so looks like this. Single, single, double, and hold it up. All right, here we go. 3, 2, 1, and begin. Single press, and single press, and double. Woo, and then we're gonna hold it up. Stay, pause for 3 seconds, and let's go back down again. Single, tuck that chin a little bit. Single, double, and big hold up, and stay, stay, stay. Do it again. Come on, push yourself. 1 minute is a long time, but you can do it. And right back up and hold. Good job, let's do it again. Now, as you're pressing up, I want you to think about pulling your abdominals tight, strengthening the core. Pull it up. Good, let's do it again. Single. It's getting tough, isn't it? You can do this. Press. Go right back up. We have time for one more, possibly two. Let's try it. Single. Single. Come on, double. And up and hold. Stay. And you made it. Whew, release. Okay, right into the next move. Bicep curls. We're taking like 10 second recoveries. So put your band under your feet. Cross the band. Ready? Set. And let's curl. Single. Single. Double curl. And then hold it at the top. Now keep your knees soft while you're in this position. Right? Do it again. Single. Single. Double. And then up and hold. Now the hold is at 90 degrees. It's not up here at the top. Let's go again. Single. Single. Double. And hold. 90 degree hold. Stay. Come on. Do it again. Single. And double. Stretch that band. And hold. If it's too easy, separate your feet. Make the band tighter. Okay? If it's too hard, take one foot out. Just keep moving. And hold. Good. We're almost there. We've just got 15 seconds to go. We can do this. And hold. Now time for one last set. Let's do it together. Ready? And single. Single. Double. And hold. Right there. Three, two, and you're done. Whew. All right. Now this next one is lunges. Remember, you get to use weights if you want to, or no weights. It's perfectly fine as well. All right, ready, set. Single lunge back. Here we go. Single, single, double is a squat, and then we go right back down and hold. Good. So another option is to have your weights up here if you don't want to have them hanging down. Your choice, squat, and then right back down and hold. Good, stand tall, do it again. Single. And double hold. Come on down. Woo, come on, keep coming. Single. And double. I know that double kind of gets tricky, doesn't it? Your brain just doesn't compute double with a squat, but do your best. And back down and hold. Woo. Come on, let's go, let's go. Single. Single, double hold, go right back down. Last set, this is it. For our lunges, get that squat, go down and hold, and you did it, unload. All right, tricep extensions. Now, this band is gonna be tricky, it's gonna be hard, all right? So you're gonna have to fight the band, work really hard. One foot on the band in the back, other foot out in front. Both arms come up, elbows are forward, and we have a single. Let's go. Single, both arms together, double, and then back and hold. All right, so single, single, double, and then go up, down, hold. Come again, single, double press, and then come back and hold. Come again, come on, really push past your head. Tuck your chin in, and then hold. Woo! And double, and hold it back. Three, two, you're not done. You've got 20 seconds to go. You can finish this. Go to burnout. Almost there. Come on, last 10 seconds. Double, and then hold it. Three, two, one, you made it. Woo! Finishing up with the band with rows, okay? Or with weights, bent over, grab your band, separate your feet, roll your shoulders back, hinge the hips ever so slightly, let's go. Single, single, double, go up and hold. Pinch the shoulder blades, not the shoulders to the ears, all right? So pinch the shoulder blades together, that's the goal here with this row. Up and hold, again, single. Single, double, and hold it up. If it's getting a little tight in the neck, right, you can pull lower. Oops, lost my band. And lower, and you can pull down here. And then you can hold right here. That's an option as well. See how the hip, the handles are lower? Your choice. And double. And hold. Pinch the shoulder blades. Elbows are low. Come on, we're almost there. Almost there. And hold it up. Let's do one more set. This is it. Single. Single. Double. Come on, hold for 3 seconds. 3, 2, 1, and release. All right. That 5 minute set is over. Nice job. Move your arms a little bit, okay? Whew. Roll the shoulders. We're gonna move into our boxing set next. I love this one. Okay, so do a couple punches across the body. Now, the key here is that when we box, we're not opening our body up, we're not punching like this, all right? We're tight, we're strong, we're boxed in, all right? So, here's what's happening first. I'm going low impact with the jumping jacks, you're going higher impact. So, jumping jacks, if you need low impact, this is what it looks like. Otherwise, do full jumping jacks. All right, so we're gonna do 4 jumping jacks, and then we're gonna add what's called a hook, all right? So we're gonna plant our feet, we're gonna punch the cheek or the side of the bag. Notice the pivot on the knee and the hip, and, okay, so get some hooks going, just throw them for me. Think about a stopping point, and you punch, punch, punch. So you've got resistance that you stop right in the middle, okay? So we're not punching all the way over like this, because what happens is we go off balance. So pivot. Pivot, use your hips, use your shoulders, use your biceps. All right, so 4, 3, do it with me, 2, and punch for 4, and that is your first action. All right, next up, toe taps. You're gonna take your weights in front of you, okay? Or if you have a bench or a chair or something like that, toe tap. I'm going low impact. You guys are gonna go high impact, all right? So, you've got toe taps right here. Perfect. 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay. And then you are going to do speed bags right up in the corner here. So you're off the side of your cheek. 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's do it again. 4 on each side. And then other side, speed bag. 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay. Next up, we've got sit-ups with jazz. So you're on the ground. So a full sit-up. If you need to use your hands to help you sit up, you can do that. Otherwise, sit up. 4, 3, 2, 1. Go back down. Rotation in the rib cage. Hips stay still. One more time. Come up. 4, 3, 2, 1. All right. After that, we've got jump rope. So obviously, you're inside. Might be hard to jump rope. So ghost jump rope, right? If you're going low impact, you're gonna do heel raises, or you can do little prances right here to keep it low impact. I'm gonna be doing this option, still nursing this ankle. All right, and after that, side shuffle with front kicks. So make sure you have a little bit of space. Again, you're gonna go fast, hard side shuffles. I'm gonna go low impact, looks like this. Side shuffle, outside leg kicks first, kick, kick, side shuffle, side shuffle, side shuffle, outside leg kick, and kick, okay? So, those are your moves. Let's put them together, have some fun. We start 5 minutes on the clock with 4 jumping jacks and 4 hooks. Ready? Go. 4, 3, 2, 1, and hook. 4, 3, 2, let's do it again. Come on, jack, 2, 3. And if you're doing full on jacks, your arms are going overhead, right? Like this, okay? Unless you need that lower arm option, that's fine. 4, 3, come on. You can still push hard even if you're not jumping. I want to see harder punches. Come on, punch, punch. Use your hips, pivot, pivot. 4, come on, a little boxing is fun in the morning or at night, whenever you're doing it. 4, woo! Should be getting to you just a little more cardio in this boxing round. Seems like that's what boxing is all about. 4, come on. Think about your punches, are they hard? Or are they just kind of wimpy punches? Are they going to have some action, some consequence? Even if you're punching a bag, doesn't matter. This is your last one right here. 4, 3, 2, 1, done. All right, and next, toe taps on the weights. So, toe taps on your weights, or whatever kind of platform you have, and speed bag. Ready, set, 4 on each leg, go. 4, 3, 2, 1, Speed back. 4, 3, 2, 1. Do it again. 4, 3. And speed back. Good. Keep coming. 4. I kind of messed up the count, so it's 4 on each side, all right? So forgive me. And then speed back over here. And do it again. 4. And I'm going a little slower than you most likely, so if you need to pick up the pace a little bit, please feel free to do that. Still doing the low impact. Come on. Now, have you ever seen a speed bag, right? It's like a little hot air balloon upside down, all right? Your goal is to keep that thing going so it doesn't come back and punch you in the face. So you're just kind of keeping it going, so nice smooth hands. Nice job. Almost there. You're feeling some action in the shoulders with that speed bag, right? It's not without purpose. Turn your head so you don't punch yourself in the face. Here's your last one. And done. All right, we're to the ground. Up next, we have our sit-up with our 4 punches. These are strong punches coming from the core. Ready? On the ground, set, and bring it up. 4, 3, 2, 1. Do it again. Up. Shoulders touch the ground, head does not rock back to the ground. So it does help if you keep your body kind of curled as you go down and then punch. Whew. Now this is getting to be too much to go down and up, right? You can just stay up the whole time and just punch, 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 hold. Punch, 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 hold, all right? So options if you don't want to take it down and up, totally fine. Dig your heels in to get that sit up and make sure the sit bones are planted firmly on the ground. Nice job. We're almost there. We've got 10 seconds to go. You can do this. And this will be our final set right here. 4, 3, 2, 1, done. Woo! All right, back up. We're into our jump rope. So starting in 3, 2, 1, jump rope. Again, I'm modifying. We're jumping rope here. We're gonna do some different kinds of jump roping. Elbows are in, hands are out. We don't jump rope like this. Okay, so strong arms. Now switch directions with your arms. Go backwards, squeeze the shoulder blades. You're doing a real jump rope. Have fun with this one, right? All right, keep going. Go circle forward again. Now, if you can do one leg, I want you to do one leg. Okay, so this is my modified one leg, just barely popping off the ground. And now switch to the other leg. Okay, so it's more of a pump. If you can see my foot, I'm just kind of doing calf raises with a supported foot. And then back right down the middle. Right down the middle. Go a little faster. A little faster, come on. Now for the final 8 seconds, I want you to go backwards. I'm gonna challenge yourself. 4, 3, 2, and 1. All right, we finish up with our side shuffles and front kick. So from the side, do that front kick. So it's a lean back to add power from the glutes, all right? It's not here. This is no power, no power. But if you lean back, you've got power. So side shuffles, outside leg kicks first. Ready, go. Side shuffle, outside leg kicks first. Pow, pow, go again. Again, I'm low impact, you're high impact. Fast feet, fast feet. You're kicking right through the ball of your foot. Come on. Bracing the core as you kick. You feel it? Ha! Ha! Nice job, nice job. If you got lots of space, use it. Okay? That lateral movement's so good for our body. We don't often find ourselves there. That's why we bring it into boot camp. Final 15 seconds. Come on. You can do this. Nice work, nice work. Get lower, get lower. Kick harder. Good job. We're going to try one more time on the other side. Let's go, let's go, let's go. And kick. Done. All right, that round is done. Get a drink of water. Woo! Next round is what you would do on dry land if you were a swimmer. All right, so we're gonna use our long band again. Alternatively, you could use a mini band, a lighter mini band, okay? And you could pull it apart on the outside, all right? Woo! All right, so here's what this looks like. Take your hands on top of your band, wrap your hands, okay? You don't have to go full tension right now, you can just practice. You're gonna stretch the band apart. You're gonna come up right in front of the forehead. Feet are about hip distance, knees soft. You're gonna pull the band apart as you press down. You're gonna pull the band apart as you come up to the top. Give it an extra little squeeze there, and then do it again, all right? So a lot of shoulders and back here with this move. Following that is, and again, if you're using a mini band, your hands won't be quite so far apart. You'd be here, here. If you have a lighter mini band, I would recommend that. Slow motion push-ups are next. So we're gonna practice on our knees. Okay, we're going 8 counts on this one. So 8 counts down to the bottom. That wasn't 8, but that was close. And then 8 counts back up. Now we're only going for 1 minute when we're in the work, so I want you to go on your toes. So I want you to go your hardest level you possibly can. Elbows back. If you need to modify push-ups, you're doing a chest press with either the band or your dumbbells. All right. After that, we are back to the top of our movement. Let's see here, band pull apart. Okay, so you're gonna take your mini band. Let me just make sure that this is where we're at. Yep, take your mini band, you're gonna pull it apart. You're gonna pull in and then press back out. Okay, so as you can see my thumb, pull apart, pull in, press out. It's a hard one for the biceps and back, but you can do it. Okay, following that, we have got a bird dog. So on our hands and knees, okay, you can also do this knuckles, or if you need to even go on elbows, you can go elbows. Okay, so we're doing opposite arm and leg, adding some pauses. Hopefully you're practicing this with me. Alternatively, you could also do this standing. You guys keep going with that. If you want to do this standing, opposite arm and leg, reaching, it's just kind of mimicking that swimming motion. And then we go on the ground and we flutter. So join me prone position on the ground, flutter, flutter, flutter. And I'm going to ask you to flip yourself over to the other side, and your arms are overhead, and you're going to flutter from this position, belly button pulling down, okay? And we'll go back and forth. It's going to be lots of fun. All right, here we go. So grab your long band, 5 minutes on the clock. Woo! So overhand grip, wrap your hands in the band, or if you're using a light mini band, pull it apart, okay? Starting band overhead, shoulders retracted, pulling down and back. Pull the band apart, let's go. Slow it down, keeping tension on the band, slow it back up. At the top, give it a good squeeze, and then do it again. Slow it down, you can separate your feet a little bit. And at the top, pull it apart. Woo! Good, tension in the band. Now I'm gonna add one more layer to this. In the bottom, you're gonna pull the band apart, okay? Work those shoulders. Apart. Feel your lats. These are the muscles that run up and down your back. Okay, they kind of connect under your armpit and then make a kind of a V shape toward the mid to low back. Okay, also might feel this right up in the deltoids as well. And obviously rhomboids right between the shoulder blades, feeling some tension too. Okay, keep it coming. We're almost there. So close. And here's your last one, big squeeze at the top, and done. All right, to the ground. This is slow motion push-ups. You are going on your toes, you're going your hardest possible level. All right, you ready? Get set, hold on. Move that forward, and here we go. I'm gonna count you down. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, you're at the bottom, push back up. Sorry, we're doing 10. I said 8, but we're doing 10. Here's 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's do it again. Elbows are soft at the top. Come on. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Slowly push up. 10, 9, 8. Come on, you got this. 4, 3, 2. We're going down again. Come on, 10 seconds. This is our last one. You can do this. 4, 3, 2. Slowly push back up, 10. Come on, brace the core. Here's 4, 3, 2, 1. Pause at the top, hold, 3, 2, One, and you made it. Sit back. Woo! Those are hard. I love them though. They're so good for our body. All right, what do we have next? Use your band. Now, I want you to go as heavy as you can on your band, okay? This one is a medium, and this one is, let's see, what is it? Extra hard, I think. It doesn't have any writing on it anymore. So I want you to get a band that feels like you cannot pull it apart anymore, all right? So pull it apart like you're not even moving the band. Pull it apart, pull it in, press back out. Ready? Let's go. Pull it apart. Pull in. Press back out. Pull it apart. Pull it in. Press back out. Come on. Pull. In. Out. Elbows stay soft the whole time. They don't ever straighten. Okay? Pull it apart. You've got so much tension going on in your upper body right now. Even if you don't have a big range of motion, that's okay. Pull. In. Out. Woo! So close. We've got 15 seconds to go. Come on. Pull. External rotation in the shoulders. Everybody needs this. And let's do one more. Open. Pull. Forward. Hold, hold, hold. 3, 2, 1. And release. Ah. All right. We're to the ground. Bird dogs are next. So if you need to do this one standing, right? Opposite arm and leg. Standing like this. You can do that. Otherwise, on your hands and knees or pausing in each position. 3, 2, 1, let's go. We're gonna hold right here. Good. And switch. And hold. And again, knuckles are a great option to make the wrists have a little bit less flexion. Good job. Now we're gonna add on here in just a moment. We've got some pulses. Just with the leg only. So hold the arm out and pulse the leg. 3, 2, 1. A little bit of glute work here. Hold. 3, 2, 1. Now I want your arm nice and strong and straight. Okay, punch. Perfect. Keep it coming. All right, next option is to pulse arm and leg together. Ready? Pulse it. 3, 2, 1. Only if you want, you can stay with just the leg only. One more set on each side. And pulse. Perfect, last one. Pulse 3, and moving on. All right, so make sure we have some space. We have our flutter kick next. So you're on the ground, arms are out in front. Flutter, flutter, flutter. We'll flip over, and you're on my count. Ready? Pull the abdominals in, squeeze your butt, and go. Flutter, eyes are looking at the ground. Okay, try to get opposite arm and leg moving and flip over onto your back. Quickly, arms and legs straight. If you need to have your legs up higher, you can have them higher. Otherwise, lower them down, pull your abdominals in towards your back and flip. Let's do it again. Flutter it out. Nice extension in the spine, lengthen your spine. Try to flip in the other direction this time. If you always flip right to left, flip left to right. Just try it. Can you straighten your legs even more? And flip. Woo, it's hard to flip in the opposite direction, isn't it? Come on. You got this. And flip it over. Flip it over for the final 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Done. Woo. Swim is over. All right. Next up, buns of steel. Everybody wants buns of steel, right? We just all know that that's a really funny term from, what, the 80s, early 90s? With lots of body oil on and glistening quads and glutes. All right, so with your weights, dumbbells on this one. All right, so kickstand. So one foot is barely tucked behind the other one. It's not back here. It's just barely tucked behind. We're gonna roll our shoulders back, and we've got deadlifts, kickstand deadlifts. All right, so a couple different options here. So the move is a kickstand deadlift, and then a squat to the side. So it looks like this. Kickstand deadlift, up, squat to the side. Okay, one more time, kickstand. If balance feels like it's hindering you, from doing that move, I want you to have both feet on the ground and do a deadlift and then a side squat. Okay, so this is the option if coordination isn't on your side today. All right, then we go to the other side. Same thing. Kickstand deadlift, do a couple of them, and then you'll add a kickstand and a side squat. Okay, alternatively, right? Regular deadlift, side squat. All right, here we go. That's that one. Next up is, let me think here. Banded leg work. So put your mini band on right around your quads. Okay, give it a try here. And we have knees to the front, knees to the side, and leg up the back. So here's what it looks like. Knee up the front, knee to the side, and knee up the back. Okay, glutes are squeezing, and then we'll do the other side. Knee up the front, knee to the side, and knee up the back. One more time. Up, up, and up. All right. Following that, we've got plie pulses. Okay, lots of fun here. So with weight, but we're just gonna do body weight right now. So toes turned out, tailbone tucked under, like you're sliding against the wall, and we're gonna pulse, pulse. Okay, looks like that. We're also gonna do some slow motion, so some two or two, 2x2 down, 2x2 up. We're gonna challenge that range and tempo. All right, so let's start with our kickstand deadlift. Ready. Woo, we've got 1 minute on one side, 1 minute on the other side. Ready, shoulders back, and let's begin. Down we go, and we squat. So brace the core, that means pull it in tight as you transition from one move to the next. Woo! That feels nice. Always reset nice and tall before you move to your next move, or next position, I should say. So the bulk of the work is happening in this front leg, okay? That's where you should feel all the work. It's your stabilizing leg. Good job. And if you don't want to move the weights up and down, guess what? You can just keep them down low the whole time. Almost there. Oops, I don't know what I'm doing. We've got 8 seconds to go. Hammy is feeling the work here. Here's our last one. Whew. And done. Little breather. I'm gonna just shake out a little bit. We're going right to the other side. Woo! All right, other foot forward, here we go. Down and squat. Now it's really important that when we squat, we point our knees towards our toes. Because sometimes we can do some funny things here with our knees as we are transitioning, right? Come on, you've got this. If this is bothering your back at all, then I challenge you to plant both feet, right? Just like so, and just step into a squat. Perfectly fine. Good job. How about 15 seconds more? Can you do that? Yes, you can. Yes, you can. Okay, you go a little bit deeper in your squat. Come on, drop it down. Good. Last one. And done. Unload. Load your mini band on your body. Woo! All right. So, standing on one leg for 1 minute. Lots of fun. Stand tall. Front knee. Let's go. Knee. Come down. Side. Come down. And push up the back. And let's do it again. Knee up the front, knee to the side. Now be mindful that your standing leg is soft, has a slight knee bend going on, and you can always use the wall. Buns of steel. Buns of steel in the standing leg as much as the moving leg. You know that, right? Good. Core brace tight. Over halfway. You can do this. Dig your supporting big toe into the ground for balance. All right, now we're gonna add pulses up each direction right here. Pulse it, 4, 3, 2, 1 to the side. 4, 3, and to the back. 4, 3, and then you're done. All right, move those hips around. Whew, that was awesome. All right, next layer is other side. 3, 2, 1, balance on that foot. Let's go, singles, up, slow. Up the side, doesn't matter how high it is. Actually, it does, not too high is what I'm trying to tell you. So not so high that you tip over, lose balance, or get out of form. Breathe through it. Enjoy the challenge of this move. Good work, good work. Really try to stretch that band. After this full cycle right here, then we're gonna add the pulses on the next time. Ready, set, pulse up the middle. Here's 4, 3, 2, bring it in to the side. Pulse 4, 3. Good, bring it in to the back. Pulse 4, 3. Come on, push that band, bring it back in, hold, and you're done. Move your hips side to side. Woo, all right, take it off. Now, if you wanna use weight, highly recommend it for this one. I'm just gonna use one weight, but my toes are gonna be turned out. My tailbone's tucked under, again, so I'm not here, but I'm tucked. All right, we're gonna start with 4 count plie. Ready? 4, 3, 2, 1, and slowly push back up. 4, 3, 2, let's do 3 and 1 right here. Here's 3, 2, 1, do it again. 3, soft knees at the top. Good, and 2 by 2, 2 down, and 2 up. Now quick to the bottom, quick down, slow, slow, slow. One more time like that, quick down. Good, now super slow, 4 counts down, 4. And slow back up, 4. Woo, one more time, super slow, and then we're gonna add some pulses. Good, slowly press back up, 4. Woo, now quick to the bottom and hold. And pulse it up an inch, down an inch. Dig your heels in. Good, stay in this range. Push your knees open. Feel your glutes squeezing around your tailbone. Almost there. Down and hold right here, down and hold. Stay for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Super slow back up. Woo, and you made it, that's it. All right. Final round in this sequence is 5 minute abs, everybody's favorite. All right, we go through it first. So you're gonna use your lighter miniband. This is my medium. All right, banded arms. So you're gonna put the band around your forearms, just like so, okay? You're gonna lay on your back, knees are bent to 90 degrees, you're gonna press that band apart. Down 2, up 2. Arms reaching straight back behind. You wanna work harder, legs reach out a little bit longer. Okay, so that's number one. Number two is soft, strong straight legs. Again, band around the forearms if you would like. And we're gonna start by lowering the legs. Then we're gonna reach across our midline, just like this. Okay, if you wanted to, you could also pull the band apart if you didn't want to have that same tension on the forearms. All right, after that, we've got a roll up. So legs are straight, band or no band, your choice. We're gonna reach our arms back behind us. We're gonna draw our belly button in, tucking our chins. We're gonna roll, 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 all the way up, and roll it all the way over. And then lift back up. You're doing this with me, right? And roll it back down. So if you need help, you can put your hands on the ground. You can bend your knees a little bit. And then you get all the way to the top. And you roll it over. All right. Next up, tabletop rotations. So we're going to take one fist to the temple. come all the way down and halfway up, all right, halfway up. So we're fighting the rotation at the top by bracing and stopping with a flat back instead of rotating open like this, okay? So again, if you needed to, right, you could also be on your elbow, just like so. A little bit more challenging, but you can do it. We're gonna have some variations, and so we're gonna do each side for 1 minute on that one, all right? So starting with our banded arms. So get your light or medium mini band, and put it on your forearms, knees at 90. Push that mini band apart, and three, two, let's extend leg and arms, go slow. We're just gonna kind of try it out for the first couple, and then I'm gonna put you into a tempo that you're going to love. Are you ready? One more single time right here. All right, now we're gonna take it four back, counts back, four counts up. Here we go. Four, three, two, and one, slowly up. Four, three, pull the belly button down and switch sides. It's four, three, two, one, pull it up, four, three, good. One more set of four on each side. Woo! Good, squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Here's your last set of four. Now, challenge time, eight counts on each side. Here we go. It's eight, seven, six, five, you're not down. Two, one, return trip, and it's eight. Seven, come on, pull, pull, pull. Four, three, two, and switch sides. Come on, lengthen, lengthen, lengthen. Four, three, two, slowly pull back up. And you're at four, three, two, one, and release. Whew, that leg felt a little bit heavy at the end there, didn't it? All right, shake out the arms. All right, so put the band back on exactly how it was, or you can choose to pull the band. Up to you, legs are straight. And here we go, reach right across your body. Good, pulling that band apart or pushing it apart, your choice. Now we are gonna take these into slower motion as well in just a few moments. One more single on each side. All right, two counts, here we go. It's one and two. And one, and two, switch sides. One, and two. One more time, on each side. Woo, do you think we can do it for four counts? Let's try it right here. It's four, three, two, hold, and slow back up. Two, three, and switch. It's four. Come on, keep pulling that band apart, and switch for four, three, two, hold, 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 and release. Whew. All right, you did it. Let's move on. Onto our hands and knees. Onto our hands and knees. Whew. All right, this one's the rotation. So fist to temple, I'm gonna put my knuckles down. Here we go, it's down, two, and stop, flat back. Do it again, down, and two. Good, keep it coming. Keep it coming, one more time like this. Good, now I'm gonna have you pause, and I want you to extend the same leg as the arm that's on the ground, all right? So now, you're gonna come in, and we're right back out. You're balancing. We're gonna have one more layer here for anybody who wants it. Here's what it looks like. You're gonna tap down, toe and elbow to the ground, and then we'll lift everything up. Tap it down. And everything back up. Good, keep coming. Woo! We've got 10 seconds left. You should really be feeling your trunk at this time. And here's your last one. Last one, and up and hold, and release. Sit back, take a little stretch. Woo, let's try the other side. So, get into position, knuckle to the ground or hand, your choice. Just the arm first, fist to temple, let's go. It's down, two, and up, hold at the top. Feels good, a little rotation under that rib cage. One more time, And now you're extending the same leg as the arm that's down. Try to keep balance. Try to keep a flat back. Keep coming. Your hips want to rotate. You're fighting rotation. All right, here we go. We add the tap down to the ground and the lift right back up. Tap down. Good. Make sure the rib cage is rotating, not just the elbow flapping. It's down, two, and up, two. Again, you've got just 8 seconds left. So this is your last one right here. Down, two, and up, hold, and release. We finish with a roll up, and then we're done with the work, all right? So, legs are straight. Glue your inner thighs together, okay? Reach your arms back at an angle, belly button's pulled down as much as it can be. Inhale and tuck your chin, squeeze your inner thighs. Roll, 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 sit up at the top and all the way over. Big inhale at the top, tuck the belly button in, roll it back. Again, here's the option. Finding that curvature in the spine, all the way over. And like you got punched in the stomach, just roll it down. You guys know I love these moves. They're so great for mobility in our back. And lift. You are so close. Can we just go for 15 more seconds? Big inhale, squeeze your inner thighs, dig your heels in. Roll, roll, roll. The more mobility you have in the spine, the taller you're gonna be, you know that? You're less compressed. We wanna be less compressed in our bodies. This is our last one, roll it up. We're gonna stay at the top here and stretch over. So grab a hold of your ankles, feet, toes, wherever you can reach. I want you to round your back here in this position, just scooping the belly button in. And then I want you to drop your elbows and lift your chest. So you're trying to think about arching through the upper and lower back. And then do it again. Round, scoop. And then flatten the back and lift. And then just slide one foot up and rotate across. Just moving into our stretch right here. Perfect. We're gonna cross this leg over. And just gently press down, sit tall. It's easy to kind of fall forward here, but just sit nice and tall. Flex your front foot. And then if it feels good, you can bring that bottom foot in. You can be on your hands, you can be on your elbows. Just adding a little bit of pressure here to pull that knee open. Actually, push the knee open. And then bring yourself all the way back up seated. And take the other leg, bend it, reach across. And cross the ankle over. Sit tall, just like so. Feels so good. And then whenever you're ready, you can bring that foot back on your hands or on your elbows, either one. Just hips and heels close to each other here. And release. All right, we're gonna take our legs wide. Take the legs wide. And just shift your arms from side to side. So if you can see what I'm doing here, just shift back a little bit. Shift side to side. Good. So you're kind of releasing the side body. You're also getting a little hamstring and inner thigh stretch. All right, now we're going all the way over. So reach all the way towards your foot, okay? Just hang out here. And I want you to start by just reaching your arms straight up. That might be as much as you go, okay? And maybe your knees need to be bent or a little bit closer together, your choice. And then just kind of keep sliding your hand toward the inside of your foot and reaching your arm over, looking up at the arm or the elbow. And then over to the other side. So reach first to the foot. Arm goes straight up, and then slide a little bit more. A lot of flexibility training today. come right back through the center. Elbows wide, okay? We're gonna just bend side to side here, lateral flexion in our body, elbows wide. And then stop in the middle, and elbows in and open. Good, now reach your arms straight up and pull down. So you feel that lengthening down your spine? Oh, if posture is an issue, this is gonna be a little bit of a challenge, but really good for you. And one more time, and release. Good, okay, bring your legs in. Ah, like, wait, don't like that. All right, so moving on, we're gonna take our legs into a lunging position with our foot pressing to the ground and our hip pressing forward here. Good, we're gonna reach both arms up. Nice, long, so as you reach, you feel that stretch through the hip flexor all the way up, and then I want you to just think about picking up out of the hip, rotating towards your front leg, stay there, then come back to the center, and do it again. Pick up and rotate, and back to the center. Good job. Tuck your toes to the ground, and hang out here. Nice low stretch. We're going to tap our knee down and up. One more time. And drop the knee all the way to the ground. Rock yourself back so your front leg is mostly straight. Might have a slight bend. Okay? If you need to hang out up here on top, you can. A little bit lower, but backs are mostly flat. We're trying not to round here. And switch to the other side. Nice lunge, shoes to the ground, shoelaces to the ground. Pick it up, lengthen, 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 and rotate towards your front leg. Come back to the center. Rotate again. And back to the center. One more time. And right back center, and we're taking our thumbs to the ground, or fists to the ground, leg back behind. And drop a knee and press. It's a great hip opener. One more time. And back knee to the ground. We rock back. Flexing our front foot. Again, you can bend the knee a little bit. This is a hamstring stretch. And very good. All right. Come to the balls of your feet here. And we're going to do some little ankle rolls. So moving around from baby toe to big toe. Just kind of massaging the feet, massaging the ankles, going the opposite direction as well. And then bring yourself up. And roll yourself all the way up. All right, guys. Let's take one arm up. We'll reach it down the back. We're going to take our palm up. Now, this is kind of a quick stretch. So, if you can see my back here, we're just going to reach and reach and reach. So, the bottom hand is turned out, okay? The top hand is pointed toward our body. So, just kind of play with this a little bit. This is a really great move to do throughout your day, especially if you're seated a lot, driving, just feeling tight, maybe you slept wrong, right? You're going to just, you're not holding these positions, you're just creating mobility. You're just creating the ability to be able to move your shoulders in these positions. Okay, so I feel like my right shoulder is nice and tight because I'm a little tan on my right side today. So if that's, you know, you just go a little easier on that side, don't push it. One more in each direction and done. Good, now you're gonna take your arms out to the side. Good, take your, right palm up, okay? Actually, both palms up. Let's try it like this. Both palms up. Now turn your left palm and rotate it so it's also up. And see how it's rotated like that? Okay. Try to straighten the arms. And now switch. Good. Just like wringing out a towel here. It's also a great shoulder mobility exercise. Also great for the forearms. Try to do this in front of a mirror and keep your arms exactly level. It's kind of hard. But that rotation, so good. And one more in each direction, and done. Whew, shake it all out. All right, last thing we're gonna do is, sorry, I wanna come back down to the ground. I should have kept us down there. Is to put our hands to the ground and just get a little forearm stretch. Okay, so just hang it out right here. If you want to do this, you could also do it standing by pulling back on your fingers if you don't want to come to the ground. Okay. All right. Circling the wrists, create some movement there, both directions. All right, we are out of here, guys. You did so awesome today. Thanks for joining me. I hope you have a great day.